What is up, you guys? Welcome to the first podcast on the channel known as Beyond the Comments and or Behind the Comments, episode 1 for this channel. This episode, I'm going to be exposing a group known as the Council of Eight. These people have been watching me for many of years, long before I ever knew of their existence. See, I did a little bit of digging, and these people have been watching me since roughly around 2013, 2014, maybe a little bit longer, from when I was dating my ex, Candle Smith, up to that point. Well, little did I know that they inserted Candle as a bug. They inserted her as a way to get me to be targeted by the council. She was the one that they sent out to draw me in. See, they had all this shit planned out from the very beginning. They planted Candle in my path so that she could draw me in after pretending to kill herself and pretending to be dead. Also, that Marty would find me and pick up on it and draw me in even further. Now, I was unaware of this the whole time until I did my research. But I'm here, like I said, to expose the Council of Eight for what they're doing. The Council of Eight is a bunch of terrorists. They're an internet terrorist cult. And the reason why I say a terrorist cult is because of the fact that they've done terroristic-like things, such as vandalizing my home, threatening people, threatening to kill people, paying off police, all so they can get away with their crimes. That's what these people do. These people come in and they do this all so they can recruit. It's all a recruiting tactic. They say that they want what's best for me, but I know that that right there is a lie. They claim to want what's best for me, but yet all their actions say otherwise. Every single action they have made says otherwise. They attack my friends, they attack my family. Anybody that shows any kind of support for me, they go after. Anytime I try to get ahead of the game and do well for myself, because as many of you know, I am a music artist and have been for many years. Every time I start to get a little bit of a head start on what I want to do with my life in music, they go in and they either steal it, they rip it away, or they do something to make it to where I can't do anything about what they're doing. These people are not good people. They are evil. They are very fucking demonic. And make no mistake, these people are very persuasive. They take everything that anybody has ever said about me and they use it to their advantage to persuade the public on what's going on. But these people are liars. These people are terrorists. They're using manipulation and mind control tactics to make the public think that I'm this evil person that I am not. And I don't know about the rest of YouTube or the rest of you guys watching this, wherever you're watching this from, but I'm about fucking tired of it. These people are not good people. They are very evil and very wicked. They will use any underhanded tactic they can to recruit. Whether it's making you look like a pedophile, whether it's threatening your family, whether it's blackmail, whether it's breaking into your family's bank accounts and threatening you that way, whether it's breaking into your family's cable account and putting stuff on there that isn't supposed to be on there, whether it's writing false reports to companies such as YouTube, whether it's putting false copyright counterclaims and putting false information in there, whether it's falsifying a document to make it look like you've signed a contract that you've not signed. These are just a few of the tactics that these evil people use. They've been doing this to me since 2017. They made me look like a pedophile, all so they can rope me in. Because of these people, I am not able to get a normal job. I've lost friends. My own adoptive dad that helped to raise me disowned me in front of thousands of people. Anytime anybody shows any kind of support for me, they go after those people. This shit is not okay. They hide in places that you wouldn't expect, like Discord. They hide in places like Reddit, where you wouldn't expect. These people aren't your typical, you know, used to be average, you know, run-of-the-mill terrorists or hackers. No, these people are hiding in plain sight amongst all of you, amongst all of us. These people cannot be trusted. These people are very wicked in their ways and what they do. The main members of the Council of Eight, which is actually a smaller part of a larger group known as the Council of 43, or something, it's got like 43 in it. But the main members are my ex-girlfriend, Candle Smith, Music Biz Marty, William Gloryhole, N-Word Boy, Kate Peters, Jay Sins. Those are only a few of the members of the Council of Eight. Along with many others, these people seek to terrorize. They seek out to destroy. They seek out to terrorize people like us, like myself, who look different. These people are very, very evil. And these people will use any means necessary. Whether it's sending someone to your house that you don't know, could be one of them. Whether it's trying to start a fight. Whether it's harassing you, vandalizing your property like they did with me. And if you guys don't know what I mean, last year, a couple weeks before Christmas, about 2 weeks before Christmas last year, these people sent somebody out here to attack my family. And the way they did that was they had somebody throw a brick through the windshield of my mom's car, which cost us over $1,000. $1,000 to replace. And before that, they did even more vile things, such as having our fencing torn down from our house, throwing eggs at our house, setting off literal glass bombs that could have killed my family and myself, shooting at me while I was on a live stream, narrowly missing me by a few feet. These people have gone even as far as to send a dead baby pig still in the mother's fetal sac in a cardboard box to my house. And now there's also threats of them sending out anthrax as well in a letter. And if you're unaware of what anthrax is, that is a very dangerous poison. Very dangerous, very, very highly toxic. But yet, the police don't want to do anything about these people. These people are very, very evil, very manipulative, and very good at what they do. When they want to make someone look like they are something that they're not, they will use any means they can. Whether it's making up screenshots, whether it's using AI voice changing programs to manipulate your voice, whether it's photoshopping something to a hyper realistic format. That's what these people do. And I've had to deal with this since 2017. Back in 2017, I was actually working for a very good friend of mine who ran a small gaming company. He was a video game designer, and I designed all the sound for the different levels of the games, making $150 an hour doing what I was doing. But because of these people, I got fired. So I then transitioned over to Twitch as a full-time streamer. These people made it look like I was doing something that I was not doing. And I ended up losing everything. I lost my Twitch account. I lost the hundreds of dollars that I was making a month. I lost all my sponsors. I lost everything. These people claim that they don't want to see me homeless, but I know that that is a lie. These people do want to see me homeless and or dead. Many of their members, many of their soldiers have stated that they want to see me homeless and or dead. And I call these people, these trolls, their soldiers because that's what they are. There's a hierarchy going on. There's a chain of command. You have the higher ups like Music Biz Marty and Kate Peters. And then below them, you have the underhands, such as N-Word Boy and William Gloryhole. And below them, you have the troops, their foot soldiers, their people, the ones they send out to attack. But above them, you have the command that runs all these troops, which is Jay Sins. Jay Sins is the man that runs all the foot soldiers and tells them what to do, tells them who to go after, tells them, hey, I want you to go after him and do this, 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 and this. And the foot soldiers, they do it without a second thought. These people are very evil people. This group is not to be trusted. Every word they say is a lie. Every photoshopped image, every video is a lie. And I do mean every video and every photo is a lie. Now, I know what they're probably going to say. Oh, but you admitted to being a pedophile. No. That is false. And for those of you that don't know what went on, and the reason why I bring this situation up is because it's very true. This is one of their manipulation tactics and what they do. This is how they blackmail a lot of the times. Because they've done this to me many, many times. What they will do is they will sit there and they'll do like what this other guy that runs with them, Tibbs TV, did to me. What Tibbs TV did is he knew that me and my dad were in a bit of a fight. My dad, obviously, you know, around that time had disowned me because of the trolls, which I was still very highly upset about. I was still very distraught and very, very hurt. But what happened next is what destroyed me. He knew that my dad was trying to go after me for something that there was no way he was going to be able to go after me over. But at the time, I was unaware of those things. I was unaware that he wasn't going to be able to do anything. So what did Tibbs TV do? Tibbs TV lied to my face. And then blackmailed me as a result. He told me, hey, like, I'm not recording or anything. I just want to talk to you. But I later would find out that he was lying to my face. But during that time period, I was unaware that he was actually recording me. So what did I do? I went in and I talked to him. But he did something that is so vile and so cruel. He blackmailed me by saying, hey, either you're going to admit to being this, this, and this, or I'm going to help your dad sue you. And me being the kind of person I am, even though my dad is a piece of shit, I do still love and care about him. I do still have a heart. I do still care about him very deeply. But during that time period, I felt like I had no choice. So what did I do? I openly admitted on a live stream, not knowing that it was being live streamed, to being something that I'm not. He basically told me, hey, either you're going to admit to this or I'm going to help your dad sue you and make sure that you end up in prison. And me feeling like I had no choice in the matter, I admitted to what I didn't want to admit to. And the reason why I was in tears wasn't because I knew that what I was saying was wrong. No. It's because I felt like I was being pushed. I felt like I was being backed into a corner that I didn't want to be in. Because I just wanted everything to stop. Now, granted, I get it, you know, and I do get it, and I know a lot of people are going to have their thoughts on this. But I love my dad, even to this day. Is he a piece of shit? Yeah, but that does not mean that I hate him. I can never hate him. But during that time, I felt like I had no choice. And that's what a lot of these people will do. They will take what you care about most and they will twist it to their advantage. These people are sick, disgusting, vile, and evil. The Council of Eight is a group that is not to be trusted whatsoever. These people are evil. They are disgusting. They are the scum of YouTube, and they need to be dealt with. These people, they say that they want what's best for me, but I know otherwise. I know for a fact they don't. These people took a career that I had in music and almost destroyed it entirely. N-word boy, who's one of their higher-ups, decided it would be cute to steal all my music that I recorded and get the copyrights to it by making a fake name by taking my first and last name and mixing up the letters. And now, as a result of him doing that, he gets the rights to a lot of my music and gets to spread these lies, saying that I'm a paid actor when I am not a paid actor. I am not what these people claim that I am. Like I said, people, the Council of Eight is a very nasty, very vile, very evil fucking group of people. They are disgusting, they are disturbing, and they need to be shut down. These people need to be exposed. These people are very evil. And I encourage anybody out there that would like to join the fight to please help expose these people for what they are, which are monsters. These people cannot be trusted. They claim to be your friends. They claim to be good people, but they are far, far from good people. Again, I urge anyone out there that does not know about the Council of Eight to please do anything you can to expose them. And if they do try to come after you, call the police in your area. And if that does not work, see if there's a way that you can get a hold of a detective or an FBI agent in your area to take a look at these guys and investigate these people. These people need to be stopped. They need to be shut down. Because what these people are doing is not okay. So I urge every single person out there to watch your backs and be very careful of these people. Be very careful of who you talk to. Because these people use any tactic they can to get what they want. These people see no bounds. They see no boundaries. They don't see right from wrong. So if you do run into any of these people, I would highly urge you to block them on any social media that you can. And if they send you threatening messages, call the police. Tell the police and make the police get involved. Because these people are very evil. And they need to be stopped before bloodshed happens. Again. Because bloodshed has happened before in the past because of these people. Long before they ever came after me. So I urge you guys to please help me put a stop to these guys before there is more bloodshed. Before more people get killed or more people take their own lives because of this wicked fucking group. With that being said, I appreciate you guys listening. Let's expose these people for what they really are, and let's put an end to this group so that we can all have a safe community here on YouTube once again. Thank you all very much. This has been Beyond the Comments, Episode 1, Exposing the Council of Eight. And to everybody out there that is joining the fight to expose these people, good luck, and may God protect you.